Hi everyone, this is Lata Akula. In our previous videos, we have completed the invertebrates. And now we'll start the chordates. Phylum Chordata. You see the chordates, why they got the name? They have presence of notochord, they are called as chordates, right? So, these chordates, they consist of notochord. In addition to that notochord, they have a dorsal hollow nerve cord is also present. This red color region is called as nerve cord. Below this blue color one is called as notochord. So, what are the characters of the chordates? They have a notochord. In addition to this, they have dorsal hollow nerve cord is also present. And paired gill slits are present for respiration. And this is the anal region. In the anal region, this part is called as post-anal tail. The post-anal tail is also the characteristic feature of the chordates only. We see the general characters. These are bilaterally symmetrical animals. What is the bilateral symmetry? If we cut the animal in one plane, that divides the animal into two equal halves. One is right and left parts. That nature is called as bilateral symmetry. And these are triploblastic animals. They consist of, in the embryonic stage, there are three germinal layers are present. That is, outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and inner endoderm are the three germinal layers present. Hence, they are the triploblastic. And these are coelomate animals. Coelomate nature means what? There is a body cavity is present between body wall and gut wall. That is called as coelomic nature. And these are the coelomate animals. And they consist of closed circulatory system. What is a closed circulatory system? Here, the blood from the heart will flow throughout the body of an animal by means of closed tubes, which are called as blood vessels. If the blood is flowing through those closed blood vessels, that is called closed circulatory system. It consists of post-anal tail. We have already described. I have already said this. This is the anus region. This part is called as post-anal tail region. And they express organ system level of organization. What is organ system level of organization? We know that cellular level of organization, tissue level of organization, organ level of organization. Here they are exhibiting organ system level of organization means different organs, they group together and form a physiologically functional system that is called as organ system. Like they consist of excretory system, digestive system, nervous system. Different types of systems are present. Hence, they exhibit organ system level of body organization. And the presence of a notochord, this phylum Chordata is again divided into three subphyla. That is, subphylum Urochordata, otherwise called as Tunicata, subphylum Cephalochordata, and the last one is the subphylum Vertebrata. If you see this subphylum Urochordata, these urochordates, they have the notochord, but where it is present? Only in the larval stage, that too in the tail region only, this notochord is persisting. But later, in adult stages, this notochord will not persist. There is no notochord in the adult form, only in the larval tail region only, not in the body, total body region, only in the tail region of the larval stages only, the notochord exists. So, these are urochordates. Examples are Acidium, Salpa and Joliolum are the examples of urochordates. And another one is the Cephalochordata. In Cephalochordata, the notochord that extends from head to tail region. In this urochordata, only in the larval stages of animal in tail region only this is present, but whereas in cephalochordates the notochord that is extends from the head to tail up to the tail that is present from starting from the head onwards, and this notochord will persist throughout the life of the animal. In adult stages of the animal also the notochord will be seen. So these are the cephalochordates. Examples for these cephalochordates are branchiostoma. Branchiostoma is commonly called as amphioxus or lancelet. So these urochordata and cephalochordata, they are often called as protochordates. But these two are together called as protochordates. This is the chordate. These are chordates, right? These are protochordates. And these vertebrates are true chordates. And these pleutocordates, their habitat is mainly, they exist, exclusively exist in the marine region only. That is in the seawater only. And these vertebrates, if you see the third subphylum, that is vertebrata, they consist of notochord. Of course, they are also having notochord that is present during the embryonic stage. During the embryonic stage, the notochord is persist. Whereas in adult stage, this notochord is modified into a bony or cartilaginous vertebral column. How it is modified in embryonic stage, it is in the form of notochord. Whereas in adult form, it will be converted into a vertebral column. If you see in fishes, in some cartilaginous fishes, it is made up of cartilage. In normal animals, remaining animals, it is made up of bone structure. Hence, it may be either cartilaginous or bony in nature. It is modified into, notochord is modified into vertebral column in adult stage. And in addition to this notochord, these vertebrates, they also consist of a ventral muscular heart. What is a ventral? This backside is called as dorsal region, and this region is called as ventral region. We have the heart in the ventral region only, right? We have the heart in the ventral region that is made up of muscles. What type of the muscles? Cardiac muscles are present, right? Hence, the heart is present in ventral region made up of muscles. And kidneys are also present for excretion and osmoregulation. To carry out the excretion and osmoregulation, kidneys are present. And we have the paired appendages. The vertebrates have paired appendages for locomotion are present. These are appendages, they may be fins. In aquatic forms, they are fins. In terrestrial forms, they are limbs. We see in fishes, there are paired fins are present, which will, by means of that, they are swimming. In limbs, terrestrial animals like dogs, cats, human beings, monkeys, all of them have the limbs. So, front two parts are called as dorsal limbs, and the back two are called as, four limbs and hind limbs are the two. In monkeys, and all these limbs are present, and we have these limbs are modified into hands and legs. So these are the characters of the general characters of the phylum Chordata. So what we have discussed is based on the presence of notochord, these chordates have been divided into three subphyla. They are Eurochordata, Cephalochordata, and Vertebrata. In Eurochordata, where the notochord is present only in the larval stages, that too in the tail region only it is existing. Whereas in Cephalochordata, the notochord is present from head to tail. Throughout the life, it is persisting. Whereas in vertebrates, the notochord is present in the larval stage. Whereas in the adult form, it is modified into a vertebral column, which is made up of a cartilage or bony structures. These are the characters of the vertebrates. These are the characters of the chordates. If we compare the chordates and the non-chordates, they exhibit some characters. So if you see in chordates, the notochord is present. Whereas in non-chordates, they do not have any notochord. Hence, the notochord is absent in non-chordates. And central nervous system, it is present in dorsal side, that is back side. And it is hollow and single. Whereas in this, the central nervous system is ventral. This ventral, and it is double. And they consist of gill slits. Whereas non-chordates, they do not have gill slits. Gill slits are absent. The heart, where the heart is present in chordates, that is present in the ventral side. The heart is located in the ventral side. Whereas in non-chordates, heart is not present in all the animals. If present, that heart is located in the dorsal side. Present in some animals, that is present on the dorsal side, whereas in chordates, it is in ventral side. They have the post anal tail is present, right? Explain the characters. the post anal tail is present. In these non-chordates, there is no post anal tail. Post anal tail is absent. These are the few comparisons between the chordates and non-chordates. What are the comparisons? Not a cord is present in chordates, it is absent in non-chordates. And in central nervous system, it is a hollow structure in single form. In this non-chordates, the central nervous system is present in the ventral side, and this is a double ventral nervous system. And the gill slits are present in these, and here the gill slits are absent in the non-chordates. The heart is present in the ventral side. In this, the heart is generally absent. If present, that will exist in the dorsal side. They consist of post-anal tail. In this, the post-anal tail is absent. So with this, we have completed the general characters of chordates. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, Lata Akula Biology Tutorial. Thank you.